The process of reforming the judiciary took a major stride forward after the president formally appointed Dr. Willy Mutunga and Nancy Barasa to head the institution. The two become the first holders of the positions of Chief Justice and Deputy Chief Justice under the new constitutional dispensation. The president also appointed Keriako Tobiko as the country's first director of public prosecutions under the new constitutional order. The three were appointed after approval by parliament.
Will as men of the opinion say aye?
Aye.
Will as men of the contrary opinion say no?
No.
The ayes have it.
While Dr. Mutunga and Barasa had a smooth ride in parliament, Tobiko survived a scare after the Constitution Implementation Oversight Committee recommended that he be investigated further, following allegations on his integrity. However, that recommendation was amended, clearing the way for his appointment. The president also appointed five judges, who together with Dr. Mutunga and Barasa will constitute the seven-judge Supreme Court, the highest court in the land, that will also be the court of last resort. The five judges, Justice Philip Tunoi, Justice Jackton Ojwang, Justice Mohamed Ibrahim, Njoki Ndungu and Dr. Smokin Wanjala, sailed through from a shortlist of 26 applicants who included current Court of Appeal and High Court judges and other legal scholars in private practice. According to the Constitution, the Supreme Court shall have exclusive original jurisdiction to hear and determine disputes relating to the elections to the office of the President. The Supreme Court shall also have appellate jurisdiction to hear and determine appeals from the Court of Appeal and any other court or tribunal as prescribed by the national legislation. All courts will be bound by the decisions of the Supreme Court. The Chief Justice, his deputy, five Supreme Court judges and the Director of Public Prosecutions will be sworn in on Monday.
With the search for the Chief Justice, Deputy Chief Justice and five Supreme Court judges over, focus now shifts to the vetting process of the current serving judges and magistrates in the ongoing judicial reforms meant to get rid of judicial officers who are deemed to be corrupt and inefficient.
Francis Gachuri, Citizen Live at 9.